In this video, we're going to talk about salts. If you recall, in the last video, we said that neutralization reactions involve the combination of an acid and a base to form a salt. So for the MCAT, you need to know that there are different types of salts that can be formed. So here I've shown examples of the three types of salts. In the first situation, we have hydrochloric acid with sodium hydroxide forming NaCl and water. What you want to recognize here is that HCl, this is a strong acid. Sodium hydroxide is also a strong base. And the salt that we form is from the conjugate base of the strong acid and the conjugate acid of the strong base, Na plus and Cl minus. Now, if you recall, when you're looking at a strong acid, its conjugate base, in this case Cl minus, has no basic properties. Similarly, Na plus, as the conjugate acid of a strong base, has no acidic properties. So that means we have a salt without acidic properties or basic properties, meaning that this is a neutral salt. As a neutral salt, if you were to take pure water and add some NaCl, the pH of the solution would be 7. Which makes sense for why we call it a neutral salt. In our second case, we have acetic acid plus sodium hydroxide gives us sodium acetate and water. In this situation, acetic acid is a weak acid. Sodium hydroxide is still a strong base. So if we look at this salt that we formed, Na plus is the conjugate acid of a strong base. It has no acidic properties. Acetate is the conjugate base of a weak acid. Remember, that's a weak base. The conjugate of a weak is a weak. So here we have a salt that has no acidic properties, but is weakly basic. So that means sodium acetate is a basic salt. Again, if you were to take a solution of pure water and you were to add some sodium acetate, you would end up with a basic solution with a pH that is greater than 7. So finally, let's take a look at our last situation. I have HCl, hydrochloric acid, and I'm going to add ammonia to form ammonium chloride. Again, we know that HCl is a strong acid. Ammonia is a weak base. So here, if we look at the salt that we're forming, we have NH4+. This is the conjugate acid of a weak base. And remember, since the conjugate of a weak is another weak, that means ammonium is a weak acid. And again, chloride is the conjugate base of a strong acid, so it has no basic properties. So our salt has no basic properties, but is weakly acidic, so that means this is an acidic salt. And again, that means if I were to take a solution of pure water and add in some ammonium chloride, I would end up with a pH less than 7. This is important for the MCAT because sometimes they'll ask questions like, if I wanted to increase or decrease the pH, which of the following salts can I add? And at first, when you look at most of the salt, they don't look like they would have much of an effect on the pH. But when you recognize whether they're the conjugate acid or base of a strong acid or strong base, I can tell you whether you have an acidic, basic, or neutral salt. So let's take a look at an example question right here. Which of the following is a basic salt? And you can see here, like on the MCAT, you have 4 answer choices. But a difference here is I'm not showing you the reactions for how the salts were formed. That means for the MCAT, you're expected to be able to look at the salt, look at the ions that make it up, and determine, is this an acidic salt, is this a basic salt, or is this a neutral salt? So in this case, we have A, KNO3. So KNO3 is made from K plus and NO3 minus. So first of all, you can take note of what the charges are, and that gives you some hint as to which one is the conjugate acid, which one is the conjugate base. So K plus, if you have a positive charge, that's going to be a conjugate acid. It came from a base of some sort. And K plus, you should know, is the conjugate acid of KOH, which is a strong base. So if this comes from a strong base, that means K plus has no acidic properties. If we take a look at NO3 minus has a negative charge, so it's a conjugate base of HNO3. HNO3 is one of our six strong acids, so that means HNO3 is a strong acid, so it's conjugate base. NO3 minus has no basic properties. So we have a salt with no acidic properties, no basic properties, meaning that this is a neutral salt. We're not looking for a neutral salt, so that of course means A is incorrect. We can then take a look at B, NH4I. Again, we want to do the same kind of analysis. NH4I is NH4 plus as well as I minus. NH4 plus has a positive charge, means it's a conjugate acid, and it came from NH3. NH3 is ammonia. You should recognize ammonia as being a weak base. So if it's a weak base, that means its conjugate acid, ammonium, is a weak acid. I minus came from HI. HI is a strong acid, so its conjugate base has no basic properties. So here, our salt has no basic properties, but is weakly acidic. So this is an acidic salt. Let's take a look at C. C, we've got LiBr, so this is Li plus, as well as Br minus. Li plus, positive charge, it's the conjugate acid. It came from LiOH. LiOH is a strong base, so Li plus has no acidic properties. Br minus, this has a negative charge, so it's a conjugate base. It came from HBr, which is a strong acid, so Br minus has no basic properties. So that means this salt, no acidic properties, no basic properties, it is also a neutral salt. So finally, we have NaHCO3, and of course, these are both wrong, which of course means D has to be correct, but let's see why. We have Na plus, we have HCO3 minus. Na plus, positive charge, it's the conjugate acid of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, definitely a strong base, so Na plus, no acidic properties. HCO3 minus, this is a conjugate base because of its negative charge. It's the conjugate base of carbonic acid, H2CO3. This is not one of our six strong acids, so this is a weak acid. The conjugate base of a weak acid is a weak base. So that means this salt has no acidic properties, but is weakly basic. So this is the basic salt that we were looking for in our answer here. All right, so that's how salts work. And again, this does mean that in order to figure out if a salt is acidic, basic, or neutral, you do need to have your strong acids and strong bases memorized. Again, with the idea that if you see any random acid molecule that isn't one of your strong acids, it's a weak acid. And similarly, any base molecule that isn't one of the strong bases is a weak base.